I left my fear by the side of the road. Hear you speak, you won't let go. Fall to my knees as I lift my hands to pray. Got every reason to be here again. Father's heart that draws me in. And all my eyes wanna see is a glimpse of you. All I need is you.
Hello, 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 church. Amen. What a wonderful time and day that we are in the Lord. Amen. And we are also as well in the power of His holy might. Amen. You know, we're just excited to be, as they say, in the cabina. Amen. We're in the shelter of the Most High God. I'm telling you, God is doing a work here in our lives. Amen. And you know, I believe that God is saying that He is wanting us to prepare, amen, for that holy mountain. Hallelujah. Hopefully there's no change in the sound. We're moving some things around here this morning in the sound system. And so probably we will be sounding a little different here today. Amen. But you know what? It's a progress. Can you say that with me? All right, Sister Tina, it's a progress. It's a progress. Amen. And so we are a work in progress. You know, sometimes a lot of things that we do, you know, we're not perfect. That was one of the statements that I made yesterday when working on some things on a project. You know, we're not perfect. God is perfect. And, you know, He's the one that's working things out in our lives to perfect those things that are not, you know. This is where we need prayer. This is where we need increase. This is where we need the power of God, you know, to literally go in there and just really soak in what the power of God is doing over and in our lives to work those things out in our lives. You know, it's something that when we have that anointing or when we have that power, you know, but just like, you know, we've heard it before, even through other areas to where, you know what, but there is a responsibility, you know, there is a responsibility that we are called. We are of the chosen, and you know what? There is a responsibility. There is a responsibility, and we have to be cautious in how we subdue what we do and even how we do and even when we do. You see what I'm saying? Just because we can, I guess the question is, should we just because we can, you know? No, just because you can, that doesn't give you the right. It's just like, let me give you an example of a policeman carrying a gun, you know. He has a right to that gun, and the gun is his. But just because it's on him, it doesn't give him the right to shoot anybody, you know, that he wants to. You see what I'm saying? Now, I know that I don't even want to go there in the frame of mind of those that we hear in the stories that they do. But, you know, for whatever reason, you know, they go through circumstances and just don't want to live anymore. I mean, we've heard stories of testimonies of even the cops. Literally, they were going to even kill themselves, you know. And there was a man of God that he's like, you know, I follow by the laws of the land. And he said that he just felt compelled to not even stop at that stoplight. And literally a cop came in from behind him. And so the man of God began to witness to the cop. Long and behold, he didn't even know that cop was wanting to kill himself. But then when he seen him miss that stop sign, now I'm not giving you a right to skip the stop signs, you know, but literally he had saved that man's life because he was compelled to do more of the job than to kill himself. His wife had left him and, you know, a lot of other circumstances going on in his life. But just because we can, it doesn't mean that we shall use it and use the power for ill. You see what I'm saying? The gifts and the callings of God are irrevocable. God gives us gifts, you know, and words of scripture, some he calls it to be talents, you know. But then also it speaks about him giving us those gifts of power. Amen. Those gifts of anointing. And truly, that's revealing the power of God here on earth. And he's choosing us for us to choose even more of him than even the powers. Amen. Did you hear that, church? Because sometimes we can desire more of the things that God can give us, even in our finances. We can desire more of we're with God because he can bless me beyond measure, anything that I can think or even imagine. You know, some people are with God, or you can say that are for God. I don't know how much they are with God, but they are for God because of what God can do for them. You know, and that's kind of scary because sometimes when you say, you know what, that, you know, I have all that access, I'm for that. Just because, you know what, at the end of the day, you know that there is a pay. You know, but it's just like me and my children. I want my children to be with me because they love me, because they want to be with me. Either or, if I can or if I can't do for them in a sense of meeting all of their needs or even all their wants. I would rather would have my children to be with me because they love me. Not because of what I can do for them. That doesn't make me a successful parent. That doesn't make me a great parent. That doesn't even make me a parent that loves them. Because and then that shows the child either to be of course, childish. And another is selfish. God's not choosing us to want to be selfish. Are we selfish in our relationship with the Lord that we're saying, Lord, please forgive me, Father God, that may it be my will and not your will. Lord, let it be my will be done, you know, on earth, because I don't know if it's that way in heaven. Surely not. If the desires are actually coming out of the flesh, are we listening? Our desires should be coming out of serving God willingly and lovingly and giving ourselves of ourselves to our Savior, to our Lord. Oh, not because He gives me the powers and the anointing of opening up the Red Sea. And yes, He gave you the mantle. Yes, He gave you the rod. But yet, when you have that authority and that power, you know, it doesn't give us the right, and I include myself in it, that, you know what, that I can will ill upon somebody else, because is not that the workings of witchcraft? Yes, the word says, and many might say, not even the word, they'll just say, oh, the book says, the good book. No, this is the Holy Bible, okay? This is the Word of God that is inspired by the living God when He speaks to us. You know what? Now, in the Old Testament, it talks about that those who curse you, to curse them, and those who bless you, to bless you. But I know in this Christian walk that if one who chooses the ill in your life, the cursing, even though that sounds ugly, come on now. When you are illing on somebody, are you not working the way of witchcraft? Are you not choosing the way of witchcraft? That you're choosing evil upon those that betrot you, that evil you, that want to pull your legs, your arms, and your muscles, and even your tendons. I mean, there are those that if they can just get your tongue and just pull it out. Because I'm sure, through these great and wonderful podcasts, people, there are naysayers that literally will listen just to disagree. Because not everybody is going to agree. Because not everybody wants to change. Are you listening? You know? Not every child that wears a dirty diaper is choosing to want to be changed. Now, there are those, hey, they come and they bring you the diaper. Please change me. But there are those that will literally run away from you and want to stay filthy and want to stay illed in their own mess. When God is saying now is the time, the hour, and the time to change. Church, because this isn't my time. This isn't Tina's hour. This isn't Tina's time. This isn't Cruzando's Ronteras time. This is not our time. This is the timing of the Lord. And I'm telling you, church, the time is now. That it is not my will or even our will, are we listening? But this is God's will. God's will, church. And He wants us, and He chooses us for us to listen in the way of Christ, in the way of the Lord, and what He has for you, and what He has for me. You know, God has these great and mighty, powerful promises, because I came in here speaking to you about a power. And I can't just stay here. I don't know about you. And I just know about me. No, God has great and mighty plans for you and for me. And we can cry out to God for help, that He is our deliverer. He is our God. He is my God. You know what, Lord? Please, don't tarry on our behalf, because many hearts will grow to be faint. And we must be careful that in which we speak upon our children, as well as our children's children. We need to pray for them. We need to intercede for them, because we could sense the ill. Are we listening? Because not everything is blessed and separated for the honor and glory of God and for His use. We as parents, we as grandparents as well, and even those as great-grandparents, that we should take it to prayer, that we should take it to an increase, that we should take it to a love, that we should take it to a faith, that we should take it until Thy kingdom come, that Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Are we listening? You know, because we can be servers of Christ and still do the things for Christ and still not be right, because we're literally headed on the way to Damascus instead of the way to the promised land. Are we listening? Because even the apostle Paul, who was once Saul, had an encounter with the power of God that literally had to knock him down his horse because of his pride, because of his situation in life, of his theology and all his technology and all of his fine necessity of speaking of eloquence with all of his powerful words. The yada da da doo doo. That literally he says, you know what? I call this to be nothing done. It is nothing for me. Because what I thought it was is not to be that of the truth. Are we listening? And we could both be serving the Lord. Amen. Let me get a little drink here. But I'm saying that we can both be going the way. But you know what? We will both be challenged differently. And I'm going to share this with you because you're my friend. And this is the word of God. Go to the book with me there out of Galatians chapter 2. And you're going to see exactly what I've been talking about. Because we're going to go to the word today. Amen. The word, as we hear it, we believe it. And it's the word that truly sets us free. Amen. So let us read there in chapter 2, verse 11, where Paul shows that Peter was in the wrong. Amen. And the word of the Lord reads, it says, when Peter came to Antioch, he challenged him to his face because he was what? He was wrong. Amen. He was wrong. Hallelujah. So let's go on. Peter ate with the non-Jewish people until some Jewish people sent from James came to Antioch. When they arrived, Peter stopped eating with those who weren't Jewish. So see, he had a problem there, eating with the Jewish people. Amen. And he separated himself from them, and he was afraid of the Jews. You see what I'm saying? It's saying that he was afraid of the Jews. Hallelujah. And then it says, so Peter was a hypocrite, as were the other Jewish believers who joined with him. And then Barnabas was influenced by what these Jewish believers did. So they were believers, yet they were Jewish. You see what I'm saying? And when I saw that they were not following the truth of the good news, I spoke to Peter in front of them all. And I said, Peter, you are a Jew, but you are not living like a Jew. You are living like those who are not Jewish. So why do you now try to force those who are not Jewish to live like the Jews? In other words, you can do this because you saying that you live this way, but you truly don't live this way. You just say that you live this way, but you choose for others and to force them to live like you say that you do, in which you really don't. You see what I'm saying? Because Barnabas here, he says, when I saw that they were not following the truth of the good news, I spoke to Peter in front of them all. And I said, in other words, there was a confrontation. Peter, you are a Jew, but you are not living like the Jew. We were not born as non-Jewish sinners, but as Jews. Yet we know that a person is made right with God, not by following the law. You see what I'm saying here? Now I'm going to read that again so that way you can understand. The word is saying that we are not born as non-Jewish sinners. We're not born as a non-Jewish sinners, but as Jews. Yet we know that a person is made right with God, not by following the law. Okay, and we know that the word of God as well is law, but it's also, we know that it's also inspired by God through the Holy Spirit. Amen. That's what makes it alive. When we, it says, because I'm trying to really not take it out of the text, because I want to stay towards the text. Yet we know that a person is made right with God, not by following the law, but by what? Trusting in Jesus Christ. Trusting in Jesus Christ. In other words, sometimes we can stick so much to the law and the law that literally kills us. You see what I'm saying? But it's by trusting in Jesus Christ. It's by trusting what Jesus has spoken and what Jesus has said. Now let's go back to scripture. And so we have what? Put our faith in Christ Jesus, that we might be made right with God. Because why? Because we have trusted in Christ. You see where it fits. Amen. Are you seeing that picture? Not by following the law, but by trusting in Jesus Christ, so that we too, that we have put our faith in Jesus Christ. So there's trusting and there's faith in Jesus, that we may be made right with God because we trust, there's that word again, in Christ. See, it is not because we follow the law, because no one can be made right with God by following the law. Because that's the Pharisees, that's the Sadducees, that's all of those that are just following by the T of the Word of God. And yes, the Word of God is truth, and the truth will set you free. But if you're using the Word of God to create bondages, you see what I'm saying? On people, instead of bringing them into the law of liberty with Christ, then that's the life that Peter was showing when he would separate himself. You see what I'm saying? Because he was afraid of the Jews. And then they called him to be what? They called him then to be a hypocrite. You see what I'm saying? So let's go on and read. We Jews came to Christ trying to be made right with God. And it became clear that we are sinners too. In other words, at the end of all this, we all have sinned and fallen short of God's glory. Amen. See, when everything came clear, they realized that we're sinners too. So does this mean that Christ encourages sin? No. That doesn't mean that we can go on willingly wanting to sin. But I would really be wrong, the Word of God is saying, to begin teaching again those things that I gave up. See, it was the law that put me to death. In other words, the law, the Word of God, has trained me to put away the things that separate me from God. In other words, I'm choosing not to do that because I know willingly that with my heart that I want to lay those things down. I want to put those things down because the law helped me with my flesh and choosing not to go other way of death in a bad sense, because there's death in a good sense when we put the desires and the things of the flesh to death so that we may live more in the spirit. You see what I'm saying? See, I was the law that put me to death, and I died to the law so that I can now live for God. See, he's wanting us that we can what? Live. Live for God. Amen? Because it's God that fills us up. You see? I was put to death on the cross with Christ, and I do not live anymore. See, That's where he was speaking, that it's no longer I, but it's Christ who lives in me. That it's no longer my will or I will, the I wills, or even thy wills. I'm just going to speak that over your life. But may it be God's will to fill me up, to be over in that increase in my life of more of Christ to live in me. See, as the word says that I still love, or I still live in my body. In other words, we need this body. God needs this body. Because he takes us and our coming and our going, and we live in this body. The Lord needs his body to transit us to go to the highways and the byways, where we can touch, where we can minister unto lives of others, that we could do this radio, amen. The airways are open, hallelujah. And you know what? We've gone to our places and our spaces to hear God's word and literally to speak God's word and to move forward in God's word. Because I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and he gave himself as well to save me. Amen. He loved me. He gave himself to me. Also what? To save me. By saying these things, I am not going against God's grace. Amen. Just the opposite, that if the law could make us right with God, then Christ's death would be useless. Did you get that word of reference there? Let's go to verse 21. By saying these things, I am not going against God's grace. Amen. As a matter of fact, he's taken us to God's grace. He's saying just the opposite. If the law could make us right with God, then Christ's death would be useless. There would have been no reason for the Son of God to come if we could only just live by the word. You know, God doesn't want us or choose us just to live by the letter. He wants us to live in the Spirit, by the Spirit. Amen. And he's choosing us that we shall not grieve that of the Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You see, as God speaks to us, he is saying, amen, and I'm just going to share this little bit, and I'm almost wrapping this up, amen. Blessings come, church, through our faith. Amen. The word of God reads, there in chapter 3, you people of Galata were told very clearly about the death of Jesus Christ on the cross. But you were foolish. You let someone trick you. Tell me this one thing. How did you receive the Holy Spirit? In other words, how did you receive this Spirit of God? How did you receive the Spirit of following the law? No. So you received the Spirit because you heard the good news and you believed it. You didn't have to go to no mountain. You didn't have to go to no sorcery. You didn't have to go to no idol. Are you listening? You didn't have to go to any of those areas in your life, and that you have put that before Christ. No, he says you receive the Spirit by receiving that of the Spirit. Amen. because you heard it and you believe the word of God. So you begin your Christian life by the Spirit. Now you are trying to make it complete by your own power. That is foolish. Were all your experiences, were they wasted? Of course not. In other words, the process, the things that God has taken us through. Was that done in vain? No. Maybe some things were done by your own power. But the word of God is saying that I hope not. Does God give you the Spirit and work miracles among you because you follow the law? No, church. God's not going to give you this work of these great big miracles because you're following the way of the law. No, he does these things because you heard the good news and you believed it. In other words, you received the word of God. You heard the word of God and you believe the word of God. And that's how the Spirit of the living God was able to work through you and for you to do the work of the ministry, to do the work of the Holy Spirit working and in through your life, to work the miracles of signs and wonders of those who follow the way of Christ. You know, I had asked the question even to my husband. I said, all who believe in Abraham believed are blessed just as Abraham was. You know what? Because he had asked, are we children of Abraham? Are we have accepted the faith as Abraham? Because God made him right with God. Amen. And he says, when we walk in this faith truly as this great seed of Abraham, which we know whom is Jesus, he is the one that has made us right with God and that has called us to be the children of the truth for those who believe by faith. Amen. That is the word, church, that I'm bringing to you today. I know that it was a mouthful, but this is a podcast. Amen. You're washing dishes, maybe doing some laundry, maybe having to cook some food. And this podcast is literally just priming your ears. And the word is saying here today, heard the word and believe. And I believe that we are hearing this word of God even for your life today. Amen. Hallelujah. That is of the promising word of God that God has spoken to us. Amen. Because he's called us to be out of that seed in the Lord Jesus Christ. He has come to save us as the Gentiles, to redeem us from the curse of the law, that Christ literally was a curse for us. Amen. Curse for us. And that is a blessing, church, here today. Amen. You can read that out of the book of Galatians 3 and chapter 13. And then let me go ahead and go to one more book. And that's going to be there out of Romans. Thank you for being patient. So we're looking into this great word of God. Amen. Because I believe that many are being set free here today through this word. Amen. We have to remember Romans 10:17. That consequently that faith comes by hearing. We hear the message, and the message is heard through the word about Christ. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing of this great and mighty word of God. Amen. How could we not hear? How could we not hear God's voice? It's premonishing, church, literally all around the world, through places and spaces, from rich even to the poor, to those who have everything, to literally those who have nothing, to those that are sick, even to those that are healed, to those that are broken, even to those that are restored. Let us pray today. Father, we thank you, Lord, for your awesome presence and who you are, Lord. Father, we know that the letter kills, Lord. And I know that you have shown us the way of life to live through the word of God. That you have come, that you have given us knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, Father God. For even the word says that your people die for the lack of knowledge. So as we receive your word, may it cut away and do away of that of the flesh, and to grow up our spirits, Lord, that we may grow into the maturity, into the way of Christ, for Christ's sake, in our lives, Lord. For it's not by might, nor by power, but it is by the Holy Spirit, says the Lord. For we thank you, Lord, here today, that we have a soundness in our minds, in our hearts, in our souls, and in our spirit. Father, you have given birth, and we walk in the acknowledgement of who you are in us. Lord, we don't want to bring a letter to kill. Father, we want to bring the truth of the living word of God. And Father, we ask, may you forgive us of all our sins. Lord, that you will wash us. Lord, that you will cleanse us. And Lord, make us holy before your throne. Our lives are open before you, Lord. Just as your word of God is open, as an open book, this is the living word that sets us free and who the Son sets free is free indeed. Through this God-given word, we thank you, Lord, for the privilege. We thank you, Lord, for your mighty power. We thank you, Lord, for the anointing. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, Rabakasandaya Bakaye. Let's just go into a small worship, amen. As we're ending this podcast. Oh, we surrender to you, Lord. We surrender to you, Father God. Oh, Rabakasata Yaraboko Shanda Yarabakasiti Yoboko Sataye. Oh, yes, Jesus. We surrender our life to you, Father God. Have your way, have your way, have your way, oh Lord, in this house. Have your way in our lives. Have your way in our jobs, Father God. Have your way, have your way from the very crown of our head to the very soles of our feet, Father God. Oh, Father God, may we not be critical, but to be radical, Lord. Let our lives be changed forever, Lord. For we no longer want to live in the same way, Lord. But to be transformed by the renewing with the Word of God in our minds. Thank you, Jesus. Have your way, Lord, within my soul. Have your way in me. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Breathe within, Lord. Lord, have your way. Lord, have your way in me. Like a mighty wind within my soul. Have your way. Have your way. Come on now. Give him some glory. Have your way. Have your way in me. Almighty God, breathe within. Have your way. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. Hallelujah. You know, that's what I usually do when these podcasts begin to close up. You know, I just get into the Spirit and begin to thank Him and glorify Him. And, you know, I just stay on the airways a little bit and just do some more praying. I want you to know that we are praying for you. Amen. I want you to know that you're more than welcome to message us. Let us know how these podcasts has truly affected your life and has literally, there has been a change and a transforming through the Word of God. Amen. I want to challenge you today, amen, that you may share this Word of God. You never know whose life that you may impacting, amen, by sharing this Word. And allow the Lord to use you today. Hallelujah. Let Him use you in great and mighty bounds. Amen. Forgiving one another and the giving of ourselves as we release ourselves unto the Lord. Amen. For such a time as this that we can give ourselves to the Savior. So once again, church, thank you for podcasting with me. Cruzando fronteras con una voz de alerta. Tu sierva con ustedes, your servant in Christ. Soaring high with you today. God bless you. Until next time, church, many blessings. Amen and amen.